everyone! Welcome back to my video Tips, Tricks and Tutorials with Natalya. And for today, we're gonna have, as you watch in this video, it's going to be my birthday. So we only not only we have in here confetti for my birthday, but also we have lots of confettis with this gorgeous diamond painting by Anne-Marie Bone. Dreams of Elysium. It's such a gorgeous canvas and so many confettis area in here. So I think this canvas needs to look more close to it. So I done about more than half already of this canvas and I start to do everywhere around. And I spot in here very good spot of confettis that we can work together on it. And I will show you some way that maybe will easier for you to follow these directions and kind of overcome this overwhelming colors of drills that is not too many at the same point in your view. If you work by the color as I do, this will be so much easier for you. And let's go to the table and we will work together on this gorgeous canvas. But before you do that, please subscribe to our channel if you did not subscribe yet, but don't double click, otherwise you will unsubscribe. Also follow us on all social media and hit the notification bell so you always know where new video is coming up on our channel. So let's go and start our tutorial. For this video, I will try to record in my craft room. And I just want to see if this is going to be better or not, because this is little room. The voice could be better. I don't know, maybe less noises from the road. We will see. But for now, I want to show you this confetti area that I was working for a few weeks. I didn't work very intense, but I still done a lot. And up there we have some AB colors, we can see white ones. So the tree is so beautiful. I still didn't finish, there is a places up there I still need to place lots of diamonds. But look gorgeous already. And this was the most like a difficult area to work on because it's a confetti area. So lots of color changing and looking through those colors, lots of pink, different shades. So when sun come out into my table and hit those diamonds, they are so sparkle that's literally blinding me. And after a while, my eyes getting crazy, kind of like a blind. So I have to stop work and work later before sun come out. Yes, and so I started work on this corner, like I got from here to here, then I start to reach out more and more, and then I'm gonna show you the other side. I started to work from another side and I have some prepared stuff in here. I always have my parchment paper ready. For this video today, I picked these 5 colors and 2 trays, and I will tell you why not 5 trays. But also I'm going to show you this side that I already working and place lots of drills as well. Maybe this way we can see where drills was placed. There, and we are working on this tree. So I pick for this video this spot in here in greens. It's also confetti, lots of same shades of green, and for some of you it's difficult part to work on for some reason. So I'm gonna show you easy way how can you create all those green symbols that is not as bad as you think. You just have to proper way to organize yourself and work, and I'm gonna show you how. So yes, this is a gorgeous, gorgeous Dreams of Elysium. And next time you will see my video, this canvas will be finished and I will show you all the beauty if you don't have this canvas yet. So look, I have drills in here. So let me close this sheet. It's gonna be a little bit reflecting. Let me try to
close this light. Now it's dark. So my apology. Let's have a little bit of reflection, but I'm gonna show you how I do. Because many colors in here I already finished. So I started my confetti, and when the most confetti was done, I moved to another side and I'm done lots in here. So there's only left kind of like in the middle in here. So then I peel my clear sheet from this side, from the other side. Then I go from left to the middle, close back, from here to the middle and the close back. So I went many colors already finished, like this light blue, darker blue, all the pinks and white, this white, I think. No, I think I finished all the whites, those AB colors in here. There's a big patch in here. All I will need on the end when I finish this canvas, I need to straighten up the beads, and that's it. So I'm gonna set up the camera and I'm gonna show you how we're gonna work on confetti. It's almost kinda I done a lot in here confetti, so we will be picking a more like a difficult spot. So that's why you have my fancy here. If you know me well, you know I like to work with these containers with Dreamer Design stickers on the top. This is Pills cases from my husband, and a few in a baggie because I didn't have enough. So we also gonna place this gorgeous AB colors as well. So let's get started. This is how I gonna start for now. So I peel my clear sheet from here, and then I put my parchment paper on a sticky part that I don't need. Also, if I wanna use multi-tray, I place my drills on the top, and you don't have to put too much drills just for in case you spill it. But here it is. If you have a good quality of drills, you will line up them so beautiful. And not every drill that I try to create beautiful lines, it doesn't work with every company, because if drills smaller size and bad quality, you will never line up nicely like this. So I pick in here two colors. Now we have in here dark air, and we have another air, but white. One go sideways, one go upwards. One is black, one is white. Now I put them behind my containers so I know exactly which color that is, or you can use a marker and write down in here symbol that you're working on it if you're afraid to mistake and switch them. But I will remember that a light arrow, it's a light color of drills, and they are laying here next to each other. Actually, I just mixed up already. It's not right. The black arrow is a light drills. I see through the thing. Okay, we're gonna switch it. So light arrow, darker drills. Darker arrow, lighter drills. All right, so now why I pick two arrow? Because if I look in here on canvas, my the most visible to me right now when I look on this canvas is a black spots, which is this black arrow. And if I zoom a little bit close to me, you can see that this black arrow kind of like jumping into your eyes. So that's why I will start to work with this, and then I have another piece of parchment paper in here. Usually I put a front of me, so if I want to reach a little bit more further up there, then I won't stick. So for now I'm just gonna zoom out a little bit so we can see better, but that's how usually I work. So we will have two trays in here, and if you wish to work at once, you know, in two colors, you can do that. You can do one by one. But why now this color with white arrow? Because it's again a darker back around. You see those patches of darker color. So that's kind of more visible to me again. So I'm going after, I'm just going to move a little bit canvas. I'm going after darker colors. It doesn't have to be drills darker, but the symbols on the canvas. So that's how I'm going to start to create my diamond painting. So in here, right in the corner of my canvas, let's get to the corner. Where is that corner? Okay, so here I have patch of black, and I'm just gonna go one by one and place first my drills on the black arrow. Actually, I'm gonna bring a tray to me, as I always like to hold in front of me, and you probably wanna see it that as well. So we're just gonna a little bit do experiment, and it's not gonna be as close to the canvas, but at least you will see how I work. Okay, so if I place in here my diamonds on the black arrow, and then let's say right in here I have diamonds that is white arrow go up, I'm just simply can jump in here and grab this as well, so I don't have to go back and forth changing the colors and later go again to this arrow. I'm just gonna keep it right now two trays at once. Now, why not more trays? What if I get clumsy and spill all of them and mix all together, and shades of green will be difficult to separate because they are all green, but some shades are very close to each other. It will be just spending time to separate them later. So I would suggest pick the confetti area of kind of same shades and just do two at once. So we go again on a black arrow in here because I can see them very well, or just use one tray and change color later to next shade. But I always pick in first darker that it's jumping into my eyes, and I think it's the best way for me not to mistake with all those green colors that's in here. Because for example, in this lighter shade colors in here, shades, there's like a arrow sideways go almost looks like a half moon, and then half moon go horizontally, so vertically horizontal, very similar on a canvas looking. But if you pick first the color that is darker shade half of the circle, then it's really kind of like it's popping into your eyes, this exact same darker color, because it's lots of them. And then I would leave the very lightest one on the very end. Okay, so we are going after this dark arrow because we can see them the best. And this area a little bit more like a patchy area, not as much confetti as was a blooming tree, but still you can see that there's lots of greens is changing in here. And also what you can do, you can place a little bit that you can reach in here, right? Now I'm gonna put three more in here. And then simply just put tray on other side, grab your other tray, and now it's again next to your color in here. You place on this white arrow, but it's darker background. so you can see them very well and it's easy to place. Just block in your mind all the other greens, because this is what you can see. Dark background with white arrow. And if you can put this into your like program in your head, you're not gonna even see the other colors in here but arrow. So let's say you work with this one and you discover that you missed this black arrow. So it's easy, let's just say you missed just the one bead. So you don't have to go all the way back into your bags to uncover color that you need. You have already tray right in here, right? So you just grab it and place, and then continue with the same color again and again. So I think two trays for beginners, it would be the best for now, just so you can get used to it, because we have lots of new family members in here at Dreamers Design that just recently purchased their first diamond painting and asking question how to work, where to start. It's could be confusing a little bit in the beginning, but this is so much fun when you get used to it. You just have to pick the way that it's more comfortable for you to work on. And if you do buy the color like I do, it's good to have a handy couple of trays and do this way with two trays for now. When you get more pro, you can use even 10 trays. If you have a big confetti area and you don't want to switch too often colors, you can handle many colors. You can put many trays in a box, fill them with the diamonds. And I do have a video tutorial how I did that, how to work with confetti area with multi trays. I think I can't exactly remember what the name was of the video, but go way back to the last year and you will find my video tutorial how you can work with multi trays, how you can store them, and easy to pick it up and put away if you don't have a craft room and you working, for example, on a dining table and you quickly have to get ready for dinner for your family, and it's easy way to pick it up, your multi trays, and put away. So watch the video, it's very helpful for beginners to help you to get used to diamond painting and start designing this gorgeous stuff. So now I'm gonna switch again to my dark drills and see, this way it's fast because you can go for example from corner to corner. Okay, I place in here already this couple shades of green, and then I see, oh, I missed two arrow symbols in here in a dark one, and I already have them in my tray and I place them, and oh, here, see, I missed one more in here. So that way it's kind of easy to go through your canvas with two colors at once. So now let's change quickly this colors for something different. Maybe even we will place some sparkle gems. Let me put this drills away for now, and I want to work with you. I'm just gonna put aside this tray totally, we'll put away later, but I just wanna show off this gorgeous drills because I have a little patch in here. We don't have put too many of them, and I have so many questions again how I line up drills, so why not to do again together, right? I think I should do this in every video, that way no questions will be asked. You can simply hold your thumb in here to close the opening of the tray. You can put towards your hand and hold it like this, so drills doesn't escape up there. And we're just gonna go spread evenly them first. and we do from side shaken to another side, and basically you just hold it, tap it, shake it very lightly in here, and you have a gorgeous lines of those aurora borealis colors. Stunning drills. And I have in here a little patch right in here, so maybe for this color I will try to bring you more close, and we're gonna readjust camera to the point so you can see there. Okay, here it is. We're gonna place on this gorgeous patch of colors. I love this beads. They look much different than other drills. It just look more higher, more 3D, perfect cut. Okay, can we see it? Okay, I'm just gonna remove this sheet for now. All right, let's place few stunning drills. I can't wait to finish and show you the full canvas, so please don't miss my next video, because we're gonna enjoy with the sparkles in full. I will bring this canvas to you in the best possible way so you can see all the beauty of this canvas. I have a little bit patch right there. And this drill's making wax in this pen not sticky very, very fast. And it's all because of this coating of glitter silver thing that kind of sticking into your wax and make wax not sticky anymore. So very often could be, if you put too fresh wax, it will pull wax out of your pen. It will stick to the bead. If your wax a little bit older in a pen, then it seems like it's working a little bit better. So we have a beautiful confetti that we placing out of focus. Let me find that space. Where is it? Right in here. You're gonna place a few more in here, because this particular color is not too much in this spot. So we'll have to like travel a little bit around the canvas. Okay, we see this prettiness. Now let me switch colors again, and we're gonna do a little bit more with the other two colors that I showed you before, that we're gonna work on this half circle and looks like a sideway, another like a sign arrow. And we will work a little bit more on this symbol as well. So now we're gonna work on two symbols. That is this. As you can see, they are like a very similar back around that many of you find hard to work, but a half circle go up and then we have an arrow go sideways. So because right now I'm looking on a canvas upside down and it's proper way towards you, so if I would put the symbols to me facing, I could make a mess, maybe mistake. So I'm holding my bottles exactly like this, upside down to me. So the symbols on the canvas looks exactly like this, and I put this bottles behind my trays so I don't mix my trays that I already prepared. And the colors really similar, especially this one, very similar to that one that we just placed in here. So now about these symbols we have, because they are both green and white symbol, but do you see how easy to separate them by the patches of dark colors? So go first, maybe always after darker color, and I will pick this one first, and I'm just simply grab a tray next to my to my hands where I'm placing from, and I'm just gonna start this color because all I see, I don't see any other colors because I blocked them in my head. All I see is a dark patch of green because we already did the other darker patch. So now it shouldn't be any dark green background left but this one. So that's what I'm saying. When you go after darker colors first, you always will be in a safe place by using a darker, but go backwards and using like from darker color to lighter. This will separate your mind not to think of any other green color. And I think it's very easy for me to work this way, and I hope this will be easy for you as well, because now all I see those dark patches, and it's really easy. I don't find this green colors dark to work at all. It's very visible the way I place them by the shades. So I hope this tips will help you, ladies and gentlemen. I know there's not only ladies in here, and I apologize last time. I say well knowledge everyone, because I didn't know we have the strong half of us doing diamond paintings as well. So I'm really happy to see the more and more men start to do this kind of craft, because it's a beautiful craft. And I'm in switch right now, and since I already placed all those darker patches of now I see all this light color, so it's easy just to grab right now and work on light color. And if I see, oh, I miss one in here, I already have a tray that I can go grab my dark one and place. And it's easier to work in multi-place tray if you have a different colors, maybe a little bit. But shades of green, it could be just, you know, you talk to somebody, mistake, and start place on different color. But if you have a blues and reds and greens in the same area, so that would be easy to work even like, you know, 5 and 6 trays at once. And you're not gonna mistake. Okay, so I will be continue to work on this canvas as till I finish. I hope this lessons today tutorial was helpful for you, and keep going, work the way I do, and you will find how easy that is to work on an area where is lots of the same color. So try and let me know if this was more easier for you after this tutorial or not. I wish you all have a good day, and I see you next time.
I hope this video was good help for you, and from now on you're not gonna be afraid of confetti area, because it is fun to do. If you do it the right way, then it's very easy. And I hope you will take my tips and tricks and let me know in the comments if this was interesting for you. because we already have so many tutorials that it's hard to find something new. But as we know, every day we have new diamond painting fans who just started, and maybe this something will be help for somebody. And I thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in my next episode. Thank you.